But this afternoon, boy, those storms just swept through.
Yeah, it really is something. It gets incredibly hot, dangerously hot. Then we get those dangerous storms moving through. Want to show you a picture sent in by Brian Davidson. All right, he's in Winter Park. We're looking at a tree that was hit by lightning and kind of torn up a little bit. He says that got about 5 inches of rain, believe it or not, in the rain gauge in his neighborhood. Brian, thanks for the picture. And as always, we love getting your weather pictures. All you have to do is tweet them or send them to us in the ULocal section of WESH.com. Here's a live look outside. Downtown Orlando still seeing rain on the lens, dark clouds off there in the distance as those heavy storms start raining themselves out just south of this location. 73 degrees in the city, beautiful. Winds out of the northwest at about 10 miles an hour. There's the rains kind of falling apart, and what we're noticing is a little outflow boundary, a gust front. As the storms collapse, all the wind goes out. So in Brevard County, get ready. The temperatures are going to start to go down, but you're going to get little gusty winds moving through. Still at this hour, heavy rains from about Windermere and Gotha back over to Oak Ridge, just south of Orlando through Conway. There's Lake Hart out around the International Airport, and all of this fizzling out, but moving over towards Bithlow and Wedgefield over the next hour's time. Just big, steady rains from Pearson, Astor, all the way down the St. Johns River, DeLand into Sanford and Longwood, all the way back to the coast, New Smyrna Beach, Oak Hill, even into northern portions of Brevard County, Mims and Scottsmore getting in on the activity. Here's Futurecast, 8 o'clock tonight. Still watching a few lingering downpours here or there, but it quickly clears out by about 10 o'clock tonight. And looking ahead to tomorrow as we wake up, mainly clear skies, but of course through tomorrow afternoon, another round of showers and storms expected. So for us tonight, 73 degrees. The rain's obviously coming to an end. Partly cloudy skies anticipated, and the model's not going with fog tomorrow morning. Now, the tropics, still something to watch out there. Dorian fizzled out, as you recall, a couple of days ago, but the Hurricane Center now saying there's a 30% chance for development. They actually flew the recon airplane out there today, and they were looking for an area of low pressure. Now, looking earlier, there was a lot of shower and thunderstorm activity. The convection's kind of waned here over the last several hours, but it's starting to show decent outflow. There's a lot going on here. First off, the visible satellite, and you can see that clear counterclockwise spin. There's rotation in there. It's just in the mid and upper levels of the atmosphere. We haven't gotten that back down to the surface, and that's why the Hurricane Center has not upgraded this back to a tropical storm. Dry air to the south, that's what originally killed Dorian. Next up, this upper level area of low pressure, which is shearing the system apart. The reason that this is all shifted around a little bit is because the models didn't indicate that this upper level low was going to start moving off to the west, and if in fact it does continue to move off towards the west, it'll allow Dorian to ventilate properly and could see this thing come to a tropical storm once again. Of course, we'll keep a close eye on it for you, and you can always get the latest inside WESH.com. Back here at home, we're going to keep an eye on Dorian. No major changes to our Central Florida forecast. High temperatures in the low to mid 90s, a 40% chance of showers and storms.